Hello Virgos, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you for the last 10 days of June. And as you know, they are all general readings. They may or may not resonate with each and every one of you. They may be your energies, energies of the person or the situation you are dealing with, or maybe the mix of both. So please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. If the reading does not resonate with you, please check your moon sign, Venus sign and the name sign. If you want to get a personal reading, the details are given in the description box below. You can also follow me on Instagram. The link of that is also given in the description box below. So let's get started, Virgos, for the last 10 days of June. Both these cards came out together, so I would like to keep it like that. Taken few extra cards. Let's see what are the messages for this deck for Virgos. Guidance from the angels. Wants to come out. Okay. Well, there was a conflict seen over here, so I took extra cards, but let's see. Anyway, so we are starting the reading with you being very, very closed off. Very, very closed off and selfish, perhaps. Self-centered, perhaps. See, what I see here is that there is something which is troubling you deep within. Okay, so you are very, very troubled about something, and that is the reason that you are closed off. That is the reason you are closed off. You are not sharing, I think either you are not sharing your feelings with somebody, or you are not sharing your possessions with somebody. You have enough, but you are not sharing. So though you have that abundance, you have everything, but you are keeping everything close to your heart. You're not sharing basically, though you have things. Now, these things can be materialistic, your money, your property, your feeling, your possessions, whatever they are. Okay, or they can be your feelings, whatever they are, you are holding them back, holding them close to your heart because of the fact that there is some pain in your heart. You are really not happy. You feel left out in the cold. You feel as if you are ignored, as if you've been rejected. It's something like that. And there is a situation over here. See, the thing is that you've been sneaky on a situation, basically. There is somebody here who's been sneaky. The behavior is very, very sneaky over here of this person, whosoever this person is. There is deception over here. Okay, so there is some sort of deception over here, which... And this deception is the reason that you are now suffering and in a very painful situation. It's like a heartbreak because of this situation in which there was a lot of deception. Cheating was there. Okay. So this is the reason of this heartache, and it has ended. It has ended, and the thing here is, this ending is followed by a beautiful beginning also, because here we have the lovers. So what I see here is that maybe whosoever this person was in your life, or this situation was in a life which was feeling you left out and ignored and feeling bad, whatever the situation was, maybe it has even passed now. This situation ended, and here maybe you are finding somebody new with the lovers card, because I think this is somebody new, because this situation is definitely ending. So if it was a relationship, this has ended, and this is something new which makes you happy, and which is a new beginning, and it calls for a celebration, maybe a commitment, maybe a family, whatever it is. Okay, so now when I pulled out these cards together, as they came out together, so what I felt at that time was, and it can be there for some of you also. See, it can be this, that this situation has ended and you are meeting somebody new. But since both these cards came out together, what I feel is it is this connection which has ended. It was a beautiful connection. It was a beautiful connection. It was blessed by the divine, it's something like that. It was a God gift to you, something like that. It was, or it started beautifully, whatever it was, but this relationship has ended because of the fact that perhaps it was not as transparent and honest as it should have been, and there was a lot of cheating over here, and because of that it has ended, because both of them came out together. That's what I feel. Okay, it can be that for some of you. For others of you, it can be that this situation has ended, the sneaky one, and you find somebody new in your life whom you want to commit to. And with the Empress, there is a new beginning, definitely. And this is something, a major event which is happening over here, because they're all major cards. So definitely with the, after the Death card and the Lovers, the Four of Wands, though is not a major arcana, but yes, the Empress is. So with all these three major arcanas, what I get here is that definitely there is an ending, whatever this is. If this relationship has ended because of the cheating, it can be that. But definitely there is a new beginning, this one or where, whatever it is, but definitely there is a beginning, new beginning over here. But the problem is that there is a conflict again. There is a conflict again. So even if this is like a home, okay, so maybe it is a home, maybe it is a commitment, whatever it is, and there is a new beginning, but again here there is an argument, there is a conflict, there is a dispute definitely over here. Again there is a dispute coming in, and you need to balance the situation. That's what I feel. You have to balance the situation with the justice card. You have to sort it out. You have to balance the situation in some way, shape or form. You have to balance this, whatever this conflict is. Maybe this conflict is arising from the previous heartache. It can be that. Or it can be with this new beginning. Again, there is some conflict with this new beginning because of some reason, whatever the reason is. You need to balance the situation. And over here, what I see is, with the Three of Wands, the Two of Swords, and with the Five of Cups, what I see is you are very, very closed off and very, very depressed. You're very upset. You're spending time alone. Very upset. You're trying to find the solutions within. And I think you're turning your back to a situation, basically. It can be that also, that whatever this new beginning was, if there is a quarrel over here, you need to balance it. Otherwise, maybe you'll have to turn your back, or maybe you are going somewhere, to some other place, or turning your back to this situation perhaps, or you're moving away, or you're waiting for the right decision, you're waiting for the ships to come in, something like that. And here you are I think you're turning back to the situation. You are totally depressed and totally secluded also, depressed, upset. It's very, very, overall the thing is that see, it can be that also, though this, whatever this thing was, it ended, there was a new beginning, but again there was a conflict. And because of this conflict, you needed to balance the situation, and again here I see you turning your back or going away, basically. That's what I'm getting, rather than waiting. I feel you're going away from a situation, leaving a situation, and perhaps even relocating, and very, very depressed, totally secluded and feeling alone, and trying to contemplate as to what has happened and why it has happened, and totally sort of a depressive type of a thing. You're not able to even focus on the positive things over there. And here again, definitely there is a new beginning over here. There is some definitely a new beginning over here in some way, shape or form in your life. A new beginning is coming here also. So definitely something is ending and something is beginning. But the problem is, why this depression and upset behavior once again? Does this new beginning also doesn't work out? Perhaps. Maybe you need to balance the situation if you want this situation, if you want this new beginning to balance, to remain there. I think you need to balance the situation well. Otherwise, this new beginning also may fall off. Perhaps. I don't know. Number 20 or number 2 may be of some significance for you. Review and contemplation. You've accomplished a great deal in your life and you have much to be proud of. Now it is a time to decide what next. As you contemplate the past and the present, you'll get clear on your divine purpose of life. Don't be distracted by the conventional thinking. Be the real you. So basically what I feel over here is that you need to realize, you need to review the situation and contemplate. And it's not that you have not achieved things in life. You have achieved things in life. You need to realize what should be done next. And for that, you need to think and contemplate on the situations and whatever the lessons you have learned from the situation. Number 33 or number 6 may be of some significance for you. Appreciate this moment. Every situation is an opportunity to grow and find love. So basically, I think it's talking about this new beginnings. Just appreciate the moment, and whatever this opportunity is, it has given you, it's going to give you an opportunity to grow and to find love again in life perhaps. So basically, appreciate this moment, whatever this moment is. Even if it was bad, it has definitely taught you a lesson as to what you should do, what you shouldn't have done. So try to review and contemplate, review the situation, what went wrong, so that things don't go wrong again. And whatever this opportunity, this thing was in your life, it was a lesson. It must have definitely grown you, okay? And it will help you in the future. It is like that. If for the past also and for the present also, which is a new beginning, you need to appreciate that new beginning also in your life, and don't ruin it by repeating those past behaviors, perhaps. So that's all I have for you, Virgos. Hope it helps, and please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. Thank you.